Hello students, in this video I'll be continuing with the Gram-Schmidt process. Now if we consider S equal to 1 1 1 1 1 minus 1 2 2 1 2 minus 3 minus 4 So this is a linearly independent set in R4. Find orthogonal basis of span of S. Since S cannot be a basis of R4, S should span a subspace of R4. So the usual process, we have V1 to be 1 1 1, V2 and V3. So we designate V1 to be W1 and W2 will be V2 minus V2 W1 inner product of W1 with W1 into W1. Now inner product of V2 with W1 is 1 minus 1 plus 2 plus 2, which is 4, and inner product of W1 with W1 is 4. So W2 equal to 1 minus 1 2 2 minus 4 by 4 into 1 1 1 1. So this simplifies to 0 minus 2 1 1. Now W3 is V3 minus inner product of V3 with W1 over inner product of W1 with W1 into W1 minus V3 W2 over inner product of W2 with W2 into W2. Now inner product of V3 with W1 is 1 plus 2 minus 3 minus 4, which is minus 4. Inner product of V3 with W2 will be, W2 is here, so we have 0 minus 4 minus 3 minus 4, which is minus 11. Inner product of W2 with W2 will be 0 plus 4 plus 1 plus 1, which is 6. So W3 will be 1, 2, minus 3, minus 4. Minus minus 4 divided by W1 W1, that will be 4 into 1 1 1 1 minus minus 11 by 6 into 0 minus 2 1 1. So this will be 1, 2, minus 3, minus 4, plus 1, 1, 1, and 1, plus 11 by 6 into 0, minus 2, 1, and 1. So this simplifies to 2 minus 4 by 6 minus 1 by 6 minus 7 by 6. Now for convenience, we can take W3 as multiply with LCM. That will give us 12 minus 4 minus 1 minus 7. So W1, W2 and W3, they form the orthogonal basis of the span of S. If required, we can also find orthonormal basis by dividing the vectors W1, W2 and W3 with their norms to get normalized vectors. Next, we have a look at orthogonal matrix. Matrix A is orthogonal if A transpose A equal to I. Now, A inverse A equal to A inverse equal to I. This implies matrix A is orthogonal if A transpose equal to A inverse. Now, the following statements are equivalent. A is an orthogonal matrix. Columns of A are orthonormal. Rows of A are orthonormal. When we say orthonormal, the inner product of any two columns will be equal to 0, and inner product of a column with itself will be equal to 1. Consider this example. Find an orthogonal matrix P whose first row is one by three, two by three, two by three. Now, if you observe, the given vector is a unit vector. Now, P is orthogonal implies rows of P आर ऑर्थोनॉर्मल. सो ऑल वी हैव टू डू इज फाइंड टू वेक्टर्स विच आर ऑर्थोनॉर्मल टू पी एंड राइट दैट एज अ मैट्रिक्स. वी नीड टू कंस्ट्रक्ट अ 3x3 मैट्रिक्स. सो वी रिक्वायर टू मोर वेक्टर्स विच आर ऑर्थोनॉर्मल टू द वेक्टर गिवन. सो लेट डब्ल्यू वन, लेट डब्ल्यू आर यू इक्वल टू 1/3, 2/3, 2/3. Let V equal to X, Y, Z be the row. So, technically speaking, the rows of the remaining two rows of P that we are going to find will actually be the orthogonal basis of U perp. Now, inner product of u v is equal to 0 implies x by 3, 2y by 3 plus 2z by 3 equal to 0, which gives us now y equal to a, z equal to b. This implies x equal to -2a -2b. So x equal to -2a -2b, a, b. This we can write it as linear combination of two vectors. So -2, 1, 0, -2, 0, 1. Now these two are independent vectors. And u, say v and w that we have, the three are independent vectors and they form an orthogonal basis. We require orthogonal basis spanned by these three vectors. Now these two are not orthogonal. This vector individually they are orthogonal to u. So to make that orthogonal, we consider W1. So this will consider it as AV1 plus BV2. So following the Gram-Schmidt process, W1 is equal to V1. So we have -2, 1, 0. So W2 is V2 minus inner product of V2, W1, 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 W1. So this is -2, 0, 1 minus inner product of these two will be 4 divided by inner product of W1 with W1 will be 5 into -2, 1, 0. So W2 is -2/5 -4/5, 1. This we can eliminate the fractions by multiplying by the LCM. So -2, -4, 5. So now we have three vectors which are orthogonal to each other. The next step is to convert them to orthonormal vectors. Now inner product of W1 with W1 is 5. Inner product of W2 with W2 is -2 squared plus 4 squared plus 5 squared, which is 45. Therefore, W1 by norm W1, this is minus 210 by root 5, and W2 by norm W2, this will be minus 245 divided by square root of 45. So P equal to 1/3, 2/3, 2/3, minus 2/√5, 1/√5, 0, minus 2/√45, 4/√45, and 5/√45. Now, if you recollect how we obtained V1 and V2, we chose arbitrary values for A and B, and hence we obtained V1 and V2. Because of this, the matrix P that we obtain, the orthogonal matrix P that we obtain, is not a unique solution. There can be infinitely many matrices which are orthogonal and has the first row to be 1/3, 2/3, 2/3. For example, P equal to 1/3, 2/3, 2/3, 0, 1/√2, minus 1/√2, minus 4/√18, 1/√18, 1/√18. Here P transpose P is equal to I. We have two different matrices with the same first row but orthogonal. It all depends on how we choose the arbitrary values.